Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the stage of history. Once more, Soul Calibur 6 unlocks in but 6 minutes, and oh boy, I am hyped. So obviously, the waiting game has begun, so I shall finish the waiting game, because once 6 o'clock comes, I'm going to step onto the stage of history for the first time ever on P motherfucking C. And oh man, I am so excited because all of my gaming happens on the PC, and we're finally getting a Soul Calibur game on the PC. It's a momentous occasion. I'm extraordinarily hyped for it. And I just can't wait. I couldn't wait. I was planning on starting the stream exactly at 6 when it unlocks, but I just can't. I need it to start now. I've been preparing as much as I could. I had a little bit of time to spare. Chances are everything's gonna fuck up like it usually does. But hopefully. Everything will go off on a hitch. We can jump right into it, and it's just gonna be amazing. Now I'm not gonna have a webcam shot because I don't want my face covering anything. I want every single bit of detail exposed and out there for everyone to see. I don't want you guys to miss a single thing. So obviously the thing that I'm most excited about is creating your own character. So the first thing I'm going to do is jump straight into the character creation, see how it stacks up to its predecessors. Soul 3 was great. Soul 4 was absolutely beautiful. Very limited, but beautiful, gorgeous. Really showing off that next-gen kind of... the next-gen vibe that the PS3 was supposed to bring in. And then Soul Calibur 5 seemed like a bit of a downgrade, but I loved the combat. It focused heavily on the combat. The combat was fast, it was fluid, it was clean, it was crisp. And I loved that. I really did love that. So, I'm definitely looking forward to seeing. And from what I have seen, from like footages of tournaments and stuff like that, the game just looks beautiful. It looks like a culmination of the third, the fourth, and the fifth game. The amazing aspect of three, absolute beauty of four, and the fluid, fast-paced combat of five. And in my opinion, that is just heaven. That is exactly what I wanted, and just shit, I'm really hyped. I'm so hyped that for the first time ever, I've never done this before, but for the first time, I actually purchased I pre-ordered Final Fantasy 15 before because I thought it was, I haven't been keeping up with it, and I thought it was still the Versus 13 thing, but for the first time ever, I pre-ordered the deluxe edition. Now that's normally something that I would never do because, in my opinion, it's a giant waste of money. I rarely ever have enough faith in a developer to give them money beforehand because, in my opinion, all it does is really excuse them. Once they've made their money back and just lets them be lazy. So I didn't want to give anything like that. You know, I'm going to go ahead and show some trailers while we're waiting for it, actually. So let me just fix that right quick. Sorry, I'm a bit sick. I'm not actually sick. It's just allergies mostly. But if I'm sniffling a lot, that's the reason. OBS has changed. Okay. What happened? No, that's not it. How do I oh fuck. Shit. What happened? Okay, that's not what I want. I don't want the dashboard. Editor, there we go. There it is. Okay, I found it. A bit blind. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and there we go. So we're gonna go ahead and check out some footage, some trailers while I'm chatting up. So yeah. So as I was saying, it's very rare that I'll ever trust a developer enough to give them pre-order bonuses to buy their pre-order stuff, because it's basically like once they make their money back and if the game's like halfway done, then they're like, okay, well now we can just be lazy. And normally I'm not a fan of doing that, but this time I was like, you know what, it's Soul Calibur 6. This is a game that I do not believe Namco Bandai can fuck up. Like, even I had full faith that this was going to be the greatest Soul Calibur game that we've ever had. We waited a long ass time for it. It's coming out for the first time in PC. This is their biggest release ever. I had no doubts that this Soul Calibur was going to be the best one. Especially since their guest character was as big as Geralt. Witcher 3 was an insanely popular game. And from the what I've seen in tournaments, like, the combat is incredible. We're going to basically look at everything that we didn't see. Like the story mode, the character creation, all that stuff. All that good stuff. We're going to see if it really stacks up to the hype. Okay. Oh my god. All right. We are good to go, folks. What do you mean the game is not released yet? It says right there. Don't do this to me. Okay, let's reload. I can't reload. Go back and reload the page. One second. Yeah.
Said yes.
And naturally, something got in my way. Alright, so I'll have to take a small 30-minute break, unfortunately, because, you know, family likes to be shit at times. So we're going to go ahead and I'm going to get everything ready, because for some reason it's not even saying that it's ready to go yet. It's telling me that it's not yet unlocked. So by 30 minutes, it should definitely be unlocked. And yeah, okay, so it's saying it's not released yet, so we're gonna keep an eye on that. 30 minutes, we're gonna come back, and it definitely should be unlocked by then, and once it is, we're gonna be all in. So I'll see you soon.
Okay, luckily, I don't have to go anymore. Alright, so, can we go in now? The game is not yet released. Let's try reloading. I really hate it when they do this. Oh, wait a minute. No. Yeah, I'm actually gonna restart Steam. I think that's what I have to do. I'm gonna exit Steam, we're gonna restart. Chat while I'm waiting for it. Close this. Go back to desktop. Just load the thing. Wherever that may be, there it is. It's Control A, it's Alt A, there we go. Library. Come on, Steam. You're busting balls here. Specifically mine. Okay, here we go. What is this? What is this updating? launch. The pains. We've waited so long and they're making us wait longer. What? What? Are you serious? What is this, some day one patch garbage? The game was finished a long time ago. Why is this happening? Stupid day one patches. Alright, well, we gotta wait all this time anyway, so. Alright, so, oh my god, it went up. No, it's fluctuating between 17 and 12 minutes. Seems like he can't make its mind. Feels bad. I suppose at this point, might as well just tune into some Soul Calibur footage. So already we're getting our classic entries. So you get to play as Inferno from the first game, who has Nightmare's moveset. Battle 2! Minutes? Is that YouTube doing that? 50 minutes? An hour? Oh crap, okay, hold on. No, we can't do that. No. Okay, close Chrome. Is it going down? Went down to 30 minutes. This is bullshit! What could be taking that long? Games only take that long when they're gigs. When it's downloading gigs. What is this? You gotta check out the downloads. Okay, we downloaded 11. Then what are we. What are. Unpacking. God damn. Maybe I should have put this on my SSD. Oh, this is gonna be killer. God damn. Kick in the pants. Oh man. So much for a fast, clean launch. Kind of looks like they put it in a RAR file or something, and in the RAR file it only amounts to 11.5 gigs, and now they're unpacking the entire thing and it's actually like 40 something gigs. That'd be crazy if that was the case. Tekken 7 was like was reported to be 60 some odd gigs. So I guess it makes sense that this game isn't exactly as small as it seems. Still though, it's pretty crazy. Oh yeah, so we're back to the 13, 14, 17 thing. So we're probably just gonna leave it at that for a while. Shit, I guess we might as well just do what this channel was kind of always good for, while we wait. Hopefully that won't kill our download or unpack or disk usage, whatever, something like that. I actually should turn off the music. Actually, I'm not even sure if it works that way on Twitch. I'm not even sure about the rules there. Oh, we're gonna go ahead and do what we do best and play a bit of Madolsh while we troll some people with Madolsh while we wait for our 15 minutes to expire. Go ahead and make this as big as we can.
Let's make it clear. There we go. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. You can go fuck with some people. Host a random game. So we're gonna have a bit of fun with this while we wait. 9 minutes to go. Alright. We're getting there. It's not fucking with us anymore. We're slowly getting there. Alright. I think they actually can't have music on, I'm not sure. Come on, man! Let's put it on, like, low. Alright, so, we'll go second. We'll see what this guy's got. It's been a little while since I played on YGO Pro. Okay, I'm still playing Scapegoat. Oh, this card is so good. This card is so fucking good for the deck. Okay, 7 minutes, 8 minutes until Soul Calibur launches. Set one pass. Folks, set one pass. Okay, okay. You know what? We're gonna start off with a special summon right quick. What you got? You got nothing. We're gonna summon our girl here, Pudding Cesar. We're gonna go ahead and summon Anjali. Anjali tribute herself off. He's got no problems. He's got no problems with this. Okay, we're going off. No fear, apparently. Wait, he's got something. No, he's got nothing. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and search. We're going to go for some damage right quick. Because I don't know what he's got, so I don't want to go too in. I want to poke him a little bit. So let's see what he's got. Our Hootcake is protected by battle. The first Monarch. Okay, so he's got Monarchs. So how much defense does this have? 2400. Jesus Christ. That's a lot of defense. Does this do anything else? This can be cheated as two tributes. Yeah, I don't like that. I don't like that at all. No, I don't want to continue the battle. Main phase 2, I would rather you have... Oh, I can't give you that, okay. You know, we're going to go for Sistart. Using these two. I'm going to go for Sistart. Set one and pass. Just to keep our Chateau protected. Actually, I think Erebus doesn't care about that, but... Card D! Card D! Okay. That's interesting. Might as well. Since your turn is pretty much over. And now you're dead. Congratulations. Okay. So we'll start off with... one, two. I'm confused. What's going on? Oh, right. I have to do it in a link marker. So we'll start off with that. And then we'll make... oh, we have Boral Load, not Boral Sword. Okay. That's fine. Go with Boral Load, actually. Actually, no. Fuck it, let's make Firewall. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and banish off Pudding Cesar to summon Pudding Cesar. Her effect to summon out Messengelato. Messengelato effect. Get us our last combo piece. And now we're ready to go all in. Oh, that's right, he's level 3. I forgot about that, yeah. But then we just go ahead and normal summon this. And then overlay. Problem solved. So we're going to go ahead and get rid of that pesky card. We'll return one to the hand. Ticket will... So bounce that off. Ticket will proc. We'll summon another beefcake. No reason to search, but maybe he's got battle fader, so we'll be ready. And then we go all in. So we'll start off with the weakest first. Five minutes until Soul is ready to launch. Alright, this guy's dead. He ain't got nothing. He's dead. This is a weird player, though. He's just like... He clearly had a shit hand. And he's just like, alright, cool. And I'll just summon card D, search a bit, and, you know, he just took it. He just took his death. Oh, maybe he had something... No, he just took his death. Fucked off. Okay. You know, alright. I should have saved that, because I have no idea what he was playing. And I could have figured it out, but I have no idea what he's playing. All I know is I saw two cards on a 60-card deck. Doesn't tell you much, but alright. So maybe we'll see more. 4 minutes, 5 minutes until it's over. Okay, here's another one with 60 cards. 60 cards is back. One day apiece, okay, solid. Scott, oh, 60-card pendulum. 4 minutes until Soul Calibur is good. 60-card Odd Eyes Pendulum. Odd Eyes Magician Sorcerer Pendulum. I suspect we're going to see some Foo plays. I doubt it, but who knows? It's possible. Oh, yes, that's right. This guy is apparently really good. So his hand effect is... you can pay 500, discard this card, add one level 8 or lower. Dragon Pendulum to your hand, it gains attack equal to... Okay, that's when it's on board, I think. Once per turn, pay half your life, or shuffle all the cards on the grid. That's pretty good. Alright, so now we have Perform a Pal Odd Eyes Dissolver. I think this is a fusion card. Yeah, it's a fusion card. So he's going to go ahead and Pendulum skill 4 and 5. So he's going to summon Odd Eyes Pendrago. Normal Unicorn. So when this card is normal summon target, one Perform a Pal monster in your graveyard, it gains attack equal to the... what Perform a Pal do you have in your graveyard? Perform a Pal... Wait, what? Odd Eyes Dissolver. Oh, okay. Yeah, no. We're gonna ogre that. No fusions for you. Okay, so this is when an Odd Eyes card is... Okay, so he's an Odd Eyes Dissolver. Okay, yeah. So he's an Odd Eyes card, so he's gonna get the search probably for another one? Search one Odd Eyes... Oh, no, he's Special Summons. Okay. But he's going first, so this doesn't do nothing. Chances are he's probably gonna go into... Or not. So it's gonna search for, I think it's listening to search an odd ice card. Yeah, okay. So this is such an odd ice card. It's gonna activate Persona. Persona, I think, boosts by 1200 when it battles. If you do place one during the end phase, your opponent activate. Okay, this does nothing. Alright. So effectively, we win. So we have a monster in our graveyard, so that kinda cucks us a little bit. Okay. But it's okay, we have a one card Angeli now. So we're gonna go ahead and summon out her. I mean, a one card Tiramisu. Use her effect, summon out Pudding Cess. We drops to level 4, 2 4s, makes our big girl, 1 minute and 17 seconds left. Tiramisu, detach, put these two back in our hand. Actually, I'll put them back in the deck, I don't mind. Get these off the field. Actually, I should probably have hit one of these, but it's okay. I'm going to overlay. 1 minute. Swing for big damage. Oh yeah, 1 day apiece. That's true. I forgot about that. Less than 1 minute till Soul is ready to go. And he top decks the Duelist Alliance. Good boy. Good boy. Top decks the Duelist Alliance. What a guy. This is the one that boosts attack values. Yeah, okay, maybe it would have been better to get rid of the, what the fuck is this? Damn, son! Ooh, Soul Calibur's done! Does this pop? Token one, special has its effects negated. Oh, yeah, sure, whatever. Okay, so let's go ahead and launch Soul Calibur. We don't need this anymore. An error occurred while updating the Soul Calibur app. What? No, don't you fuck with me like that. You can play that shit. There we go. All right. Here we go. All right, so now we're gonna set up a game capture. Soul Calibur, Shixid. Okay, capture specific window. Where art thou? I should probably close PS. Okay, there we go. Capture specific window. Soul Calibur 6. here we go. Yes, we are in. We don't need keyboard controls. We're using a good old gamepad. I have been awaiting this for a long, long, long while. Bandai Namco Entertainment, powered by Unreal 4. Oh man, I've been longing to see those images for a long ass time. Project Soul. Soul Calibur 6. Beautiful. Soul Calibur 6. Okay, we get the policy. Nobody. Does anybody ever actually read this? I'm not sure. I don't. I'm a law-abiding citizen, so I don't think I need to worry about reading it. No, I don't need no gray areas to exploit, so we're good. And there's the sextant right there. The sextant loading symbol. I'm ecstatic. Ex-flippin-thatic. Getting a smooth 60 frames. Come on, come on, come on. Get me in. I want to go in. Here we are. We're in.
Transcending history and the world. A tale of souls and swords eternally retold. Soul Edge. A legendary sword and devourer. Darkest reaches of history. It was brought back to light in the 16th century. The notorious pirate Cervantes claimed the sword as his own, setting everything into motion. Soul Edge adapted itself to its new owner by splitting into two. Possessed by the evil weapons, Cervantes began a bloody reign of terror, slaying all those seeking the swords without prejudice. Cervantes was eventually undone. Under the protection of Hephaestus, the god of smithing, a female warrior named Sophitia was able to destroy one of the swords. Shards of the blade flew and lodged into her body, causing near mortal wounds. Seeing his chance, Cervantes raised his sword to deliver the final blow. Suddenly, there appeared a ninja known as Taki, who rescued the wounded warrior. Taki defeated Cervantes in a battle to the death before carrying the injured Sophitia away. However, one of Soul Edge's two blades still remained. Perhaps it was fate. The blade fell into the hands of Siegfried, whose mind was twisted and unwell.
Damn! Now that's a sword with power!
Pierced the heavens, the product of rampant evil, the evil seed. No one could have predicted it would become a catalyst for catastrophe across the world.
I'm a hero.
The story takes place in the 16th century.
It's good getting a little background, culmination of history. Welcome to Soul Calibur 6. This is the main menu, where you can choose between different game modes and enjoy the different content Soul Calibur 6 has to offer. Libra of Souls is a mission mode in which an existing story unfolds around a character of your creation. Along the way, some missions will allow you to play through battle tutorials, so it is highly recommended that you play through this mode.
Well, alright then, we're going to be doing that.
You can adjust the controller settings from the options menu, or by selecting controller settings in the pause menu. Once you get a feel for the game, be sure to customize your controls to match your playing style.
I'll definitely be doing that.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we are in!
Okay, let's hop straight into creation. I think actually in Libra of Souls you just go into creation, but I want to get a feel for it. And then I'm going to go straight into a fight. I got to customize my controls because I like custom controls. I never do default. Actually, that's a lie. Sometimes. Very weird. Whatever.
Welcome to character creation. Character creation lets you choose from a variety of options to build your unique character or customize a regular Soul Calibur character. Character creation is divided into two tabs. Unique, make a new character from scratch. Customize, create your own character based on the other player's character.
Whoa, fuck. My bad. So we're gonna go unique. We wanna create our own, whoops, no.
wait. Am I in unique? Yes, I think I'm in unique. No, maybe not. There we go. Okay, now I'm in unique. Original character creation. Design a character from your from the ground up. Blah, 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 blah. Okay, cool. I want my own unique character. Soul Calibur 6. Oh, that's true. There's a bunch of races. Oh, that's true. We got a bunch of races. Lost Soul. A resident of the Astral Chaos. These lost souls have large wings which they use to soar through the pandemonium of their plane with divine grace. Though they dwell within the heart of chaos, they seek order and mercilessly attack all those corrupted by darkness. That's cool. Okay. Alright, this is cool. Forgotten people who have lived deep within the mountains of Europe, they're said to be descendants of those cursed by the gods. They're part beast and present acute senses because of... Okay, alright, so these are beast people, angel people, got human lizard men, mummies. Mummies, that's cool. Okay, so they're like undead. Alright, that's cool. Oh, we have automatons. That is amazing. Like fucking Soul Calibur 4 with, what's her name? God damn, she was using ass. Oh, that is cool. Shapeshifters. Okay, that is cool. A Colossus. Granted life by... Oh, that is cool. That is awesome. Okay. Malfested. Fully transformed. Okay. Mutated. Regular. Revenants. Darksiders. Lost Soul. Okay, this is cool. That's cool. Oh, and elves too. Okay, that is cool. Oh, man, that is cool. I don't even know where to begin. Oh, shit. Alright. Let's, Oh my god. I don't know. Okay. I kind of want to be a Darksider. Maybe. No, I don't know. I don't know. I genuinely do not know. What class am I going to play? What's my first class? Let's go with Alright, let's start with human first. We're gonna check the customization options for both male and female. So first, okay, so we're locked into what's Shishio? Oh, that's like the that's like in Soul 3. Oh no, okay, we can change other okay. Awesome. Sophidia, Siegfried's my boy. Oh, we can play as Aswell too. That is awesome. Oh, and we can have Gerald style. What? Oh, for the first time ever, we get to use the guest character style. That is amazing. That is amazing. Oh, that is awesome. That is truly amazing. Okay, I'm gonna go with Zoslamel for now. That is incredible. And we have all of his like weapons from Star. That's awesome. And they don't manipulate stats, so you don't have to. You can pick the one that you like the most. This is cool. Outrageous. Okay, so we have like presets, I think. Okay, so this does affect their stats. Okay. Okay, reach minus one, no reach effect, okay, alright, okay. Alright, so we're gonna go for a tall guy, gonna go for a thin. Okay, so you can update like every, okay, this is awesome. Let's give him some thick thighs, let's give him some like slightly thicker thighs, there we go, that's good. We're gonna go minus five. Calves, we're gonna beef up a little bit too, because you know leg day is important, folks. Leg day is very important. These are so reminiscent to four. Okay. Wait, do we get like previews? We don't get to preview, no, do we? No, we don't get to preview, but it's all right there. It's all right there. Okay, so we're gonna go. Let's see. Let's get this one. That's really young. Okay, we're gonna go. I want a nice, It's a nice beard. No, that's not it. This one. I want the beard and the mustache. There we go. Okay, we gotta change that hair right quick. We're seeing the Soul 4 hairstyles too, and some new ones too. Oh my. Alright, that's for like the special ones. Oh, we got some new hairs. Oh, we got, like, this is Gro's hair, I think. Yeah, that's Gro's hair. Oh, this is like Super Saiyan Gro's hair. This is like some, oh no, this is Aswell's hair, I think. That's cool, we get like to use the, that's cool, okay. I'm not saying the classic spiky one, no, I'm not, it's like one of my favorites. This is Gro's regular hair, yeah, that is one. You know, we don't get the spiky one, that's so sad. That was like my favorite. The one that just spikes. Oh wait, is this it? No, that's slicked back. That's not it. Oh wait, that's Mohawk. Short Rage. I don't think that's it. Nah, that's not it. That's really unfortunate. That is so unfortunate. This game was so close to being perfect. I don't get my spiky hair. I don't know. Maybe we'll get like, I don't know. Maybe we have to unlock like some other hairs. Maybe. That's probably what it is. Alright, so we'll go for this. These eyebrows are fine. Young. Oh, the Soul 4! Yeah! I love the voices. Oh, they're from Soul 3 too! Ah! Oh! Oh my god! Bravo! Oh, does that mean. Okay, didn't have the one I want, but this should be this fight. Why do you choose to fight? I can see the fear in your eye. What this fight? I can't run away. I won't hold back. You will die. It doesn't have all of the ones that I love, but why do you choose to fight? I can see the fear in your eyes. This'll be easy. Still, I like this. I like this. I like it. I'm happy. I'm more or less happy. Alright, so what is this? Equipment. Edit manually. Oh, okay. Okay. This I'm gonna leave like that. Oh, does this like. Oh, that's nice. That is nice. I like that. That is nice. Alright, let's see what we got. Yeah, I think we have to unlock more stuff later. I think that's how it goes. This looks like something Raphael would wear. A rubber unitard. Oh, I like that. I like that. We got a great starting selection, though. Oh, that is cool. That looks like a fucking Starkiller's, kinda. Oh, that's Valdo. That is definitely Valdo. Definitely Valdo. Valdo. Oh, these outfits look great! Looks great! Oh, this is Oslamel right here. You have access to the core character shit, like, right from the get-go. This is great. This is looking like, what's-his-face, the wolf guy, it's to my tongue, shit, I don't remember, I just don't. Oh, and this is, like, Nightmare? Oh, this is awesome. This is awesome. This is totally awesome. This is just cool. It's so awesome. I'm thrilled. I'm thrilled. Like, I just can't say it enough. I'm absolutely thrilled. I'm thrilled. Us conflicts. Okay. That's unfortunate. I can go for this holster, maybe. It would be nice if we can, like, shrink it a bit more, but it's supposed to be, I don't know. And now we can go for a tacit. This kind of looks like Assassin's Creed-ish. No, not mine. Never mind. This is definitely Siegfried's redemption. It's all about redemption. Truth Seeker Stola. Oh, that is cool. That is sick. That is that is sick. Oh shit. Like, dual gender stuff. Gender and... Nah, I won't say gender ambiguous, because it's not really, but... That's cool. Oh, that's sick. This is just... This is great. I love it. I love it. Oh, it's very asymmetrical, which is really cool. I'm digging the asymmetrical thing. Let's see what other options we have. Oh, I think this is from, like, Soul 3. Oh yeah, that's from Soul 3. That is definitely from Soul 3. I dig it. I so dig it. I love the throwbacks. Archangel Gauntlets. It's also pretty cool. That's a bit of Soul 4 right there. Oh, this is sweet. This is just awesome. I'm gonna go back to the ones that had Redemption Gauntlets. Those are cool. I dig the asymmetrical thing. On the classic shoulder plates, these were my favorite in Soul 3. Just like to get the matching thing. Let's see what else we got. Oh, is that like a off shoulder, like a side? It's not as long as I hoped, but it's still pretty nice. Oh, another classic. This one's from Soul 4, I think. I don't think we're going to have Holdrens. I don't think so. Or maybe, yeah. We'll have the Redemption ones. Might as well. Oops. We ain't done yet. Oh, yeah. We didn't go through this stuff yet. Sword Demon Leg Guards. Zossalamel's Lower Body Garment. Warlock's Pants. I think we can change the color of everything after. I'm gonna go for this. Yeah, we skipped over that. We did. So next, the socks don't really matter too much. I'm not gonna see them. So we're gonna go. Oh, the goat legs! Fucking goat legs! I think we get all this customization if you get like the pre-ordered version. I think that's why. I think all of the. I think, like, these are basically. Yeah, I don't think I can. Yeah, I can't put anything over these. Which is fine. You get to put accessories and stuff to add more depth to your character. And here's where you do all your you can do all at once. Okay, so we're gonna start off from here. Yeah, black hair is fine. Yeah, we're just gonna start off nice and simple for now. I don't wanna take too much time in it, but like clearly, like I don't even need to say anything. Like it's just, oh, you can even, oh, that is amazing. That is truly amazing. You can modify the fucking weapon itself. That is amazing. That is incredible. That is fantabulous. That is incredible. Oh my god. They've outdone themselves. Akubo and his team have truly outdone themselves. Magnifico. Does it let you actually... No, it doesn't actually change in real time. It's weird. The thing always looks purple. It's weird. Battle comments. I was like, text things, I guess. This is awesome. Actually, no, that would be more suited towards this. Where was that? You're wide open. Where's that? Was that here? Anyways, we don't need to get crazy with this. It's cool. That's really cool. So we're gonna go ahead. Can we, like, rotate the cam? No, that's not, it's, I want to move him to the side. Rotate character. That's not what I wanted. Okay, I don't know what any of these mean, but we'll go with it. That is a stark improvement. There we go, alright. Oh wait, we can actually adjust, I think we can adjust the frame. Oh, we can! There we go, that's what I wanted. That's what I wanted. Alright, that'll be good for now. Oh, they even give you like a custom name. We'll start with Masaho for now. And we'll do a mock battle, just like to practice, customize the controller a bit so we're all like fluid and motion tabulous. Oh, okay, what was that? I mean, I know what that was, but how did I do that? I really hope that they gave us the option to have, like, PS4 commands, because, like, I know that this has been a thing forever, but I never get used to it. LT trigger is, okay, it's the long one, so it's the bottom one. So then I used RB, which is grab, I think. Is that a grab? Isn't that grab? I can't remember what B is. B is the vertical, I think. Okay, I think I want that to be, I think that's what I want. Alright, this is grab. Hello?
Hi.
Hi. Possibly. On what card? The capital?
Yeah.
No, you never put anything back in it.
Yeah,
I put
the 120.
Oh, last I checked, it didn't update.
Okay, well, it should have updated now.
Oh, I'll have to check.
Okay, can I give it then? Call Domino's, order the same thing you had last time, the 3D.
Okay. Okay. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. Bye. Sorry, folks. All right. So, pizza time, apparently. Which is never a bad thing. Okay, so this is okay. RT. Isn't that a grab? I'm pretty sure that's supposed to be a grab. I mean, it used to be a grab. Okay, well, hold on. Yeah. Okay, so let's try it. Okay, so it's not a grab anymore. Okay. So it's not a grab anymore. So then, I think grabs might be different. Maybe I should check the tutorial. No, that's Okay. Okay. Okay, so maybe there's only just one grab now. Oh, okay, it's a direction. It's a directional grab. Oh, I get it. It's a directional grab. Okay. All right. Okay. Okay. I comprende. I should actually call for pizza. Otherwise, I don't eat. Crap, I forgot the number. Okay, no. Go back to type A. Actually, is there a custom? Custom. Well, I mean, I just want to modify type A. Okay, so A, B. Okay, so I think that's grab. So in this, I actually don't think I need that to be programmed. Okay. What's that? Yes, hello, it's for delivery. The same as last. 3640 Boulogne, Rossart. Yeah. Yeah, can I add a garlic dip to that too? Yeah. Thank you. Wait, I actually should verify that. Yeah, my bad. I just wanted to verify there are three pieces, right? No, it's okay. Are you afraid? Are you not afraid? See you in hell. Just watch. Stay down. Okay, no, that's not the right one. No problem. KG. Oh, KKG. KG. Okay, so that's also a reversal there. Okay. Sorry. It's for the wrong number. try 514-774-8997. Yeah, that's the one. Perfect, thank you. Can I also keep the two sauces, the marinara and the garlic one, please? No, one garlic and one marinara. Thank you. Thank you very much. You too. Bye. Okay, that took unnecessarily long. I probably lost all of my my viewers a while ago, eh? So I guess there's no point in streaming. Well, it's a bit unfortunate, but life goes on. Anyways, thanks for watching, and you guys should get it, or whoever ends up watching this should get it. If no one gets it, well, I hope you got it anyways. Peace!